The formula for calculating employee turnover is fairly straightforward. You take the number of separations during a certain time period, you divide that by the average number of employees during that same time period, and then you multiply your result by 100 to get a percentage, and you can report that percentage. But there are lots of nuances to take into consideration, like different employee types. How do you account for full-time versus part-time, or employees who are on a leave of absence? So I created an employee turnover calculation workbook that you can download. I'll include a link in the description below this video. If you're interested in purchasing it, you can download this and it will show you everything that you need to know to accurately and consistently calculate, track, and report on employee turnover for your organization. Let's take a look at the different tabs that are included in this workbook. So as I mentioned, the way to calculate employee turnover is to take the number of separations in a period, so by month, divided by the average number of employees in that month, and then multiply that result by 100 to get your percentage. But let's take a look at what goes into those different factors of the formula. For your number of separations, this is going to be your total separations, so both voluntary and involuntary of all employees. You're not going to count anyone who's an independent contractor or a temporary agency worker, only people who are on your organization's payroll. You're also not going to count in this number of separations anyone who's on leave, because those leave employees will be counted as average headcount. So that brings us to the next factor in the formula, which is the average number of employees. So you can take different data points of headcount throughout the month. So if your HRIS system allows you to run a point in time headcount, you could run one at the beginning of the month, the 15th, and the last day of the month, and you'd have three data points. You'd add those together and divide by three, and that would give you your average number of employees throughout that period. And again, you're going to include all full-time and part-time employees in that headcount. You're just not going to include anyone who's not on your payroll. So contractors, temp workers, anyone who's a volunteer will not be included in that count, but you will include those employees who are on a leave of absence. Even if they're on an unpaid leave of absence, you'll still include them for your headcount. Now, if you run a report every week, maybe you have a few extra reports to include in that month, you would just add those together and divide that by the number of reports that you have for that month, and that will give you your average. What I've done for this spreadsheet that we'll take a look at the next two tabs, I've included data points that you can put the point in time headcount at the beginning of the month and the end of the month, and it'll take an average of those two. All right, the reason we multiply by 100 is to convert this number to a percentage. But in this Excel spreadsheet, I've actually formatted those cells as a percent, so I don't need to include the times 100 as a factor in the formula. But if for any reason that you don't want to format your cell as a percentage, you would want to include the times 100 as a factor in your formula. So we'll take a look at that. Now, if you decide you want to download this workbook, I have three tabs that are included here, and I'm going to show you what's on each tab. There is a turnover calculation tab that you can actually input your headcount data points. So if you know your headcount at the beginning of the month, and then your headcount, say, at the end of the month, and then your total number of separations for that month and hit enter, then your January turnover rate will automatically calculate for you. And as you continue to fill in this spreadsheet, if you come over to the second tab, which is the turnover report tab, you'll notice that we have this linked so that all of your monthly turnover rates will populate out here for you. So you can keep a running total. If you need to report this out to your leaders, you'll be able to do that. It then will also automatically calculate your quarterly, and then at the end, your annual turnover rate. So your quarterly and annual turnover rates are simply going to take your monthly turnover rates and add them together. So that's how you will calculate your annual turnover. Now, this last tab over here is a handy sample that you can refer to and get you brainstorming about ways that you want to report this to your leaders at your organization. So talk to them about what's important to them. Do they want to see a breakout of voluntary versus involuntary terminations? Do they want to see that activity of employees transferring between departments? Maybe they want to break this out by department or even by region or by office location. So depending on your organization and what your leaders are interested in looking at in terms of HR metrics, talk to them, find that out, and then you can create something like this to to report on them and to create kind of a dashboard or report view that you can then include in different Word or PowerPoint reports. So for example, this is just a sample that you can see we've got different departments broken out. You would be able to input the headcount at the beginning of the month, track all of the hires in voluntary and involuntary terms, as well as the transfers. And then you would have a headcount that would automatically calculate at the end of that month. And then it would calculate your January turnover. So this is just a sample or example that you could create for yourself and use. Now, keep in mind, if you do download this and use this one, if you delete rows or add them, you're gonna have to adjust your formulas. So this is just sort of an example that you can go by. Once you have this middle tab, the turnover report completely filled in, you can actually create a bar chart graph. So let's say we had this filled in, we can select it, and then we can say insert, and let's include a chart here and a 3D column. And this will build a chart out for us. So once this data is populated, you can easily create a chart for it, and again, copy and paste this chart into your Word report or your PowerPoint report. If you found this video helpful, be sure and give it a thumbs up to like it. You can subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Be sure and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time.